Hello, PokéDudes and PokéDudes. Welcome back to Pikmin. Last off, we began the series and looked for the engine of the dolphin, and now we're heading to the Forest of Hope in search of more of the items and hopefully some new friends. So, first of all, you can see we're in a pretty closed off area. My dolphin has returned to the surface along with the Pikmin's onion. Beginning alone on this strange planet makes me somewhat uneasy. So I shall call the Pikmin out of the onion. All I need to do is stand in the light beneath the onion and press A. Darn right you do. Not again. Are one of you there? That one's yellow. No one else is not doing anything. Nice bright color, bright. cast down a bit of brightness. Oh, we got more. Almost done. There we go. One more. Bada boom. Let's go have a look at the... Why, it's the Eternal Fuel Dynamo. It has unlimited energy... It has an unlimited energy supply. I wouldn't have to worry about saving electricity anymore. This will make my flight for survival a bit easier. But I said flight for survival, instead of fight for survival. Item number 2 for the ship. This should light things up. No more candles for me. I've now recovered 2 parts. Just need to find 3 more and I should be able to increase my ship's capabilities. Now I'm gonna take what I've got. Oh, they actually did do something. The clock is indicated becoming immune. From now on, I must pay close attention to the sun meter on my monitor. Choose actions accordingly, so it's best for me to review monitor's data. Across the top of my monitor, sun's display, button the space suit, down the Pikmin gauges, on the left, the number of Pikmin on a man. Pikmin on the field, Pikmin in total, and Pikmin in the onions. To just monitor, I can press Z to rotate the camera, press up right, and do the hello. Only one? meet everyone. So you carry him. Not all of you. The colour is different, but it seems to be a Pikmin nonetheless. First glance suggests this one has what, in some circles, would be considered to be very large ears. It looks like it may weigh less than the others. In what other ways might it be different from the red Pikmin? I must be sure to observe it closely. I can hold the Pikmin for a moment with A. Then swap it using B. Of course, we're gonna do that. I can't exactly get the reds to do anything, so get the yellows to. Pikmin has picked up a particular stone. Why it decided to grab it? This action seems to be instinctive to the yellow Pikmin. But what are these strange glowing stones? Brightly glowing cracks cover them. Perhaps these cracks indicate that there's tremendous power locked away within. This merits further research. I made yet another Pikmin-related discovery. Just when I was about to exceed 100 Pikmin in the field, the onion stopped expelling seeds, yet the total number of Pikmin continued to climb. It seems that once there are 100 Pikmin on the field, subsequent seeds get stored in the onion, thus no more than 100 Pikmin can be on the field at any time. The yellow Pikmin picked up seems to be explosive stones. Perhaps they know that these stones can be used as powerful weapons. The bomb rocks are dangerous, so I must take care in using them. There should be a blast. Aim to blast the stone, you must be loaded for the weapon. Carry on. Give them all this. Yeah. trees. Whimsical radar. This important item can detect the locations of other missing parts. The radar will be added to my monitor, which I can press plus to view. Up and down zooms in or out. This will surely help me in my research finding those parts. I've now recovered 3 of 30 parts, just need to find 2 more, and this should be able to increase my ship's capabilities. The clock is indicating the approach of sunset. Pikmin are waiting beneath the dolphin, and onions will probably enter the onion on their own. But if I don't call the stragglers, and add them to my group, they cannot be able to get back. I'm sure that the Pikmin still planted are safe, but I am somewhat concerned about leaving Pikmin to fend for themselves in the darkness. Let's just hurry up and get this done. I'll start to how many yellow Pikmin I have. Let's just check from the map. Got a few items, we can get that one. We can't get that one yet. We can get those two, that one, and that one. I think I'll try and go for that one that's over there. And maybe one of those two. Or that one. Hey, good day. That was good. I need to keep things like this up a bit more when it comes to playing this game. Nicely done. Already ahead of schedule, that's all good. Day 2 since impact, it appears that many of my ship's parts have landed in this region. If I can just recover the parts of my radar, I should be able to use my radar screen. How that will improve my chances, then only I'll have to find them. Yeah, it seems to be many hostile life forms there. If I'm attacked, and my spacesuit takes damage, I must return to my ship. Standing in front of it and pressing A will surely make my suit repaired. As I explore, I must pay attention to the suit's damage meter in the bottom left corner of the screen. And of course, there's the stats for this. We've already gone over 100 red, but I'm going to work with the yellows next time. And of course, thank you guys so much for watching. I have been PokéDudes Red. If you're enjoying the series, don't forget to subscribe. But without further said, hit that bell notification if you want to be notified anytime you want to see a Pikmin or Tokemon sessions or WWE 2K17. And I'll see you guys next time. Goodbye.